think of one of the best rock stations in America, Always and Forever. I think of The Pig, of course. I think of the little powder blue t-shirt that I still have in my collection.
I think of Super Jam, Bush Stadium sold out in 1978, and a host of other amazing shows.
Our success in St. Louis was tied very closely with KSHE's radio support. And I think the kind of music we made, that kind of Midwestern white guys singing very high, higher than they should, you know, was very conducive to the audience in St. Louis. And it's always been a joy to come here and play.
Crazy thing about playing a drive-in, we'd never done that before, and it was not, there was no PA or anything. People had the drive-in speakers in their windows, and that's how they listened to the concert, kind of a thing. And they would beep their horns for applause, and it was, we maybe only did one or two more like that, so it was a very unique thing. We're playing a drive-in theater in St. Louis, you know, it just kind of... But it was our chance to sort of get a toe in the water down here. It's a good feeling. It's a
rock and roll feeling. I just remember KSHE was that was my first real radio station interview, and I just remember driving out there and being in the car, and I was like nervous because this, you know, I've been hearing about this radio station forever. Now I'm going to be there and go on the air. It was like there was a lot of new experiences for me that were coming up back then, and that was a big one. Is it any wonder I've got too much
time on my hands, sticking away with my sanity? We were probably as popular and as successful in St. Louis as we were anywhere in the country. It was a very big town for us. You know, going back, we played the Ambassador Theater with Dr. John. When I think of Lorelei, my head working on the Equinox album at a club here in St. Louis. We were there playing for a week, and we had the whole club to ourselves in the daytime. We worked out Light Up and Lorelei and Sweet Madam Blue right in this town. We played the Keel with Frank Zappa. We weren't big stars yet. You know, we were scruffing and trying to make it to the top, and Zappa wasn't told that there was going to be an opening act, so he was furious that it wasn't an evening with Frank Zappa. So he only allowed us three microphones in the Keel, one for each singer. We were not allowed to mic any of our instruments. And Keel's 10,000 seats. Well, you can't hear it. So at the end of the 40 minutes, the people went, "Ooh, you suck," and we did.
I remember sold out Bush Stadium, which was the biggest show we've ever headlined to this day.
Super Jam 78. Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the
long arm of the law. I remember standing there and looking, because you know how it looks from the inside there. For us, because it was such a huge and historic show for us, but even on that day, just looking at it, We knew what it was, and we knew that it would be an unforgettable day.
I mean, for me, I remember playing a guitar solo, which we used to do in very Hendrix style, which of course I was heavily influenced by, and just hearing it reverberate throughout this giant place with 40,000 people, and I go, better get it right tonight.
I think we probably all still have that aerial photo, because it was from a helicopter. Yeah.
High five, my brother.
Fantastic.
All right.
What a great honor. Well, we did this together.
Yes, we did. I'm
sailing away. Lots of shows and lots of airplay and lots of support from the people, you know. And the fact that it's still one of the greatest places for us to play, I mean, that's a testament to you guys for keeping it going.
When we reunited in 1996 after not working together for 13 years with Tommy and the band, the first show that got put on sale was St. Louis. Our managers felt like we were, you know, our strength here was going to show the rest of the country, the rest of the promoters, and boom, I think we had Styx with Kansas opening, sold I think 7,000 tickets over the first weekend after we hadn't been here in a long time, and but that kind of set the tone for us getting back together and really, you know, set the tone for what we're doing here today.
It did, and we were looking to those figures when we first got back together. Our manager said, you know, if you guys put tickets on sale, people will come, and we're like, you know, let's see, because we didn't know, you know, so much had changed during that time. We've had this relationship for a long time, and it's been true, and it's in here. And it always will be. And thank you so much for your support and your love for us. Believe me, it's mutual. To carry on.